हर हर महादेव। हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ सुदीप शाह एंड आई एम अ न्यूमरोलॉजिस्ट एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब एंड IGTV चैनल। इट्स अ वेरी स्पेशल डे। टुडे इज़ द फर्स्ट मंडे ऑफ सावन मंथ, द मंथ ऑफ देवाधिदेव महादेव। डू कमेंट हर हर महादेव इन द कमेंट बॉक्स बिलो एंड आई प्रे टू देवाधिदेव महादेव सो दैट ही ब्लेसेस एवरी वंस लाइफ विथ हेल्थ हैप्पीनेस एंड प्रॉस्पैरिटी। टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस ऑन अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक। आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फ्यूचर ऑफ द इंडियन स्टॉक मार्केट। येस, आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेडिक्ट द फ्यूचर ऑफ द इंडियन स्टॉक मार्केट विथ द हेल्प ऑफ एस्ट्रोलॉजी फॉर द सेकेंड हाफ ऑफ 2020। So over the past few weeks, actually, I was getting a lot of requests, like where people wanted to know about my views regarding the future of the Indian stock market in the last 30 days. Okay, so we have seen three eclipses, two lunar eclipse and one solar eclipse. So we have seen three eclipses in the last 30 days. So people wanted to know whether we are going to see another downtrend or not, whether the Nifty and the Sensex will hit the circuit breakers or not, or whether the bull run will gain a new momentum. Okay, so in this video, I'm going to try to answer all these questions with the help of the principles of financial astrology. So before I begin, I'd like to request you to please subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon so that you do not miss my upcoming videos. So, and I would also like to add one disclaimer that this video is purely based on the principles of financial astrology and should be treated and is intended only for educational and informational purpose only. The facts present in this video should not be treated as trading advice. You should always remember this thing in mind that investment in stock market is subject to risk, and I would request you to kindly consult your financial advisor before you make any kind of investment in this market. Now, everybody is asking one question, like the number of corona cases are going up, both in India and the world. So now in this scenario, how the market is going upward, like, because this is normal question, right? So today I'm going to answer this question, try to answer this question with the help of astrology. See, this bull run is purely happening because of astrology only, because of the planetary alignments only. Okay, so see, in traditional astrology, Saturn is the significator of economic recession or depression, and Jupiter is the significator of economic development. And in astrology, 10th house is the significator of career and business. And if you look at a Kalpurush Kundali, you will see that the 10th house belongs to Capricorn zodiac sign, Makar Rashi, which is ruled by Saturn. Now listen carefully what I'm saying. Whenever Saturn, Jupiter, Rahu, that is the north node, Ketu, the south node, Uranus, Neptune, Pluto, okay, these seven planets, I'm repeating it once again. So whenever Saturn, Jupiter, Rahu, the north node, Ketu, the south node, Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto, whenever any of these seven planets, they make a connection with the Capricorn sign. Whenever any of these planets, be it one or be it multiple, they make a connection, either a direct connection or an indirect connection through aspects, whenever they make a connection with the Capricorn sign, markets will crash. Okay, this is rule number one. Rule number two is whenever any of these planets, any of the seven planets, okay, is transiting in fire sign, water, fire zodiac signs, Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius. These are the three fire zodiac signs that are there in our horoscopes. So whenever these seven planets or any of the seven planets are transiting in fire zodiac sign, markets will crash. And the last rule is, whenever any of these seven planets are conjunct or opposite to each other, markets have fallen. Now I have went back in time, I have studied the chart of the Great Depression of 1929, the Great Recession of 2008, market crashes of 2001, 2004, 2018, और सभी में यही समीकरण बना था. ओके, तो आज हम दो चार्ट्स के बारे में डिस्कस करेंगे. वन इज द ग्रेट डिप्रेशन ऑफ 1929 एंड द सेकंड इज द ग्रेट रिसेशन ऑफ 2008. सो इन ग्रेट डिप्रेशन ऑफ 1929 व्हेन दिस थिंग हैपेंड, यू सी एट दैट टाइम both the Rahu, that is the north node, and Saturn, they were in fire sign. To be more precise, Rahu was transiting in Aries and Saturn was in Sagittarius. Then Jupiter was aspecting Capricorn and Saturn and Pluto were opposite to each other. So you can see that all these factors which I've mentioned, these three factors had led to the contributed to the Great Depression of 1929. Now let us talk about the Great Recession of 2008. What happened there? Here, Saturn, Jupiter, and Pluto, they were transiting in fire zodiac sign. Jupiter and Pluto were in Sagittarius, and Saturn was in Leo. Okay. Rahu and Neptune were in Capricorn. And Mars was aspecting Capricorn, that is an external factor. But these are the two factors, as I've mentioned, that three points. So like these three points have contributed to the Great Depression of 2008, Great Depression of 1929 and the Great Recession of 2008. अब 2020 के मार्च में भी यही हुआ था, जिसके वजह से all the indexes had nearly lost 50% from their top. तो ये था अब तक की कहानी. अब आगे क्या होगा? Are the markets going to fall again in 2020? Yes, they are. Yes, the markets are once again going to fall in 2020. The bull run that is happening right now is purely happening as per the astrological combinations, that is as happening due to the planetary combinations. अब मुझे एक बात मुझे बताइए, इस bull run के पीछे fundamental क्या है? The economy, the GDP data, they are hitting all time lows, unemployment at record high, businesses are closing, means there is a crisis all over the world. And इस crisis में stock market क्यों आगे बढ़ रहा है? क्योंकि planetary positions ही ऐसा है. Now, as per my estimates, this uptrend will continue till the 15th of July, plus minus 7 trading sessions. You can take margin of plus minus 7 trading sessions. So this will continue until the 15th of July 2020, plus minus 7 trading sessions. Okay, तो 15 जुलाई के बाद ही आपको मार्केट में वीकनेस दिखने लगेगा. तो ये चलेगा आपका फर्स्ट ऑफ अगस्त तक चलेगा. हियर अ न्यू लो इज वेरी अनलाइकली. मुझे नहीं लगता कि न्यू लो बनेगा, बट as per my estimates, astrological estimates, I can see that the Nifty will fall below 9000 and we are going to see the 8000 levels once again. Now again on 16th of August 2020, both sun and mars are going to transit to their natal sign, that is the aries and leo. Now similar combinations happened in April when both these two planets were in their exalted sign, और यही से हम लोगों को market में recovery देखने को मिला था. तो यहाँ इस transit के बाद we are going to see another round of recovery and इसके आगे market ऊपर जाता रहेगा. Now again on 23rd of September, the Rahu and Ketu, they are going to change signs, zodiac signs ये लोग change करेंगे. And on 29th September, Saturn is becoming direct in its own sign, that is natal sign Capricorn. तो ये जब राहु केतु ने साइन चेंज किया है तब यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट द अनएक्सपेक्टेड थिंग्स. ये लोग क्या है कि ये लोग इल्यूशन क्रिएट करते हैं. सो हियर आई कैन सी इन द फर्स्ट वीक, इन द लास्ट वीक ऑफ सेप्टेम्बर और इन द फर्स्ट वीक ऑफ अक्टूबर, आई कैन सी अ माइनर डाउन ट्रेंड इन द स्टॉक मार्केट. A minor one, as per my calculations, it is going to be a minor one. Okay. Again, on November 20th, Jupiter will once again transit to Capricorn sign. Capricorn, जो कि Jupiter का नीच राशि है, but Saturn के presence के वजह से यहाँ पे Jupiter का नीच भंग राजयोग हो रहा है. But फिर भी markets पे ये negative असर डालेगा. And we are going to see another major downtrend in the month of December, first week. Okay, December first week में एक major downtrend देखने को मिल सकता है हम लोगों को. और यहाँ पे 7511 को शायद market test कर सकता है और एक new low बना सकता है as per astrology. Okay, so यहाँ पे new low बना सकता है. तो अभी present scenario में इस मार्केट में फ्रेश इन्वेस्टमेंट करना उचित नहीं है एज पर एस्ट्रोलॉजी. दिस इज द टाइम टू बुक प्रॉफिट एंड एग्जिट फ्रॉम द मार्केट एंड वेट एंड वॉच. ग्रह नक्षत्र अनुसार, मैं फिर से बता रहा हूँ, ग्रह नक्षत्र अनुसार अभी नए इन्वेस्टमेंट करने का समय नहीं है. तो फ्रेंड्स, आज के लिए बस इतना ही. मिलते हैं अगले वीडियो में. Please like the video, share your feedback in the comment section, and don't forget to share this video with your family and friends. Till then, namaste.